I've got Steve with me today, and he's got an electric threader for steel conduit. We're never going to get hands on one of them in the workshop, but you can, obviously, in the industry. So let's see what Steve gets up to. Again, no hacksaw for Steve. He's in with his reciprocating saw in order to cut the conduit. He's going to cut through the conduit, making sure he keeps his hands out of the way. And there we go. That's it cut. Again, pretty square. I would suggest Steve should square the end up. I'm letting him get on with however he wants to do it. He's got a spray on lubrication now and a mains powered. They do a battery version as well. Conduit threader. So he pushes it onto the end. You notice it's going down the conduit now. I'll slow it down in a minute as he increases the lubrication. So I've slowed it down there. So it's cutting the threads. Adding the lubrication this time as we go until we get down to the desired length. So down it goes. See, this is a lot easier. See the swarf dropping out as before, then it's dropping out to stop that bad thread. Click the button, reverse the process now, so I'm going to wind it backwards. So it's coming back off the conduit now. As it goes backwards, obviously cleaning that thread up. You can just take it off. Once we've done, we'll see what the thread looks like, and obviously it's considerably easier. Remember, you're going to be working maybe in the electrical industry for 40 years. If there is an easier way to do it, I always suggest you take that easier option. In with the reaming tool again. Super important that we don't leave any sharp edges. Clean it up. You can see now that running edge is now nice and smooth. Could use a round file. We're using a reaming tool for this one. Steve's just going to wind his box on now. So he's done his threads long enough to go into a spouted box. I hope this video has been some help.